As you all know, everything has gotten way more expensive lately. Food, electricity, brewing ingredients, yeah, and even beer. And even if you are a home brewer, you can really feel it. Like the electricity bill after an 8-hour brew day eats up the profit faster than a boilover. But what if I told you could skip all that? And even if you are not a home brewer, we may have found a way to cut prices on beer altogether. I'm Dr. Hans, this is Dr. Hans Brew, this is my shirt, but... I'm Dr. Hans, this is Dr. Hans Brewery, my channel about beer and homebrewing and lurking in the shadows. We have Chewy. What I'm about to show you legally contains no alcohol. That's why we didn't put any ABV on the labels. That's why also it avoids alcohol taxation entirely. Because this isn't beer. Yet, not until it hits water. Inside of each tablet, there is concentrated wort and a hyper yeast strain just waiting for it to be activated. And when it hits water, it ferments instantly, literally in seconds, producing alcohol and CO2. You're not buying beer, you're buying the potential to brew beer instantly. This is InstantPint. As these are sold as non-alcoholic product, there's technically no age restrictions, so you could sneak these into like a concert or something, but don't be an idiot and handing a glass of fermented InstantPint to a child. And for the product launch, this comes in 3 flavors. We have the Hazy IPA, and the Pilsner, and the Belgian Triple. And each tablet is meant to be fermented in 500 milliliters of water. Best case scenario, you should use RO water, because this comes with brewing salt to fit the style, and hopefully you would have a pH of 7 in that water you use. But to be honest, if you have like really good soft water, you could use that. But if you have really hard water, and as this comes with brewing salts in them, you might have that cake on cake effect and your experience might not be optimal. RO, store-bought, or I do have, as I also have really hard water here, because my water comes from my own well, I do have a video on how you can soften up your water. But today, we're actually going with store-bought here. This might sound like a gimmick, I get it, but we're gonna hear all the science about it, but I'm eager to try this on camera as the NDA just been lifted second quarter of 2025. So each pill are optimized for 500 milliliters of water, but you can experiment with that. But if you instead would add a pill of Hazy IPA into 330 milliliters of water, you would get a double Hazy IPA, or you would get a Belgian quadruple. The Pilsner would probably get into a Imperial Eisner. So feel free to experiment with the amount of water, and if you want to do like a session Hazy IPA, just add more water. But whatever you do, do never put a pill directly into your mouth. Believe me, we tried it. I set this to milliliter, but you could also set this to gram, team metric, buy the t-shirt. So 500 milliliters, or should we be crazy and like spice it up just a bit? I found like the sweet spot for me on the Hazy IPA is about 440. 442, okay, close enough. Let's drop a pill. Are you excited, Chewy? Are you ready? Here goes nothing. So the fermentation like start instantly. This is super cool. Starting to get some color also. Let's see, the magic appears in front of you. See if you can get some head on there also. Like trying to swirl this up. It usually takes about 30 seconds for this to ferment. Smells nice. And now we're starting to get both some color and some head on this bad boy. And I think it's done. And the shelf life of this product is remarkable. This is super fresh IPA, screaming of hops. I think that the science behind it is like it's 0 to no moisture in those pills at all. and with the SpaceX plastic in these tubes, but we're gonna hear everything about the science behind this from an actual expert. But here goes nothing. Cheers. You wouldn't believe that it comes from Bill, and I know that this sounds way too good to be true, right? And the science behind this goes a little bit over my head, to be honest. You weren't supposed to see this, but as the pills are already dropped, I guess I can fill in the blanks. Dr. Haas didn't even get the name right. It's InstantPint, not InstaPint. This is not a beer in a pill. This is a result of extreme yeast engineering, fermentation physics, and questionable ethics. Let's break it down. The core of every InstantPint tablet starts with a yeast strain pulled from the wilds of Patagonia, an ancient, resilient, aggressive yeast strain, Saccharomyces abionus. We cross that strain with Quipe, already a monster, and train it here, out in outer space. Then we subjected it to repeated cryocompression, vacuum desiccation, radiation stress cycling, until only the strongest yeast cells survived. After hardening it, we crossed it with Saccharomyces cerevisiae for our ale strain and with Saccharomyces pastrianus for our lager strain. As of today, we have only two strains of InstantPint, one ale strain and one lager strain. Everything else is experimental. For a Belgian trip pill, we needed something to get the funk. So I added something special that I cultured myself. It gave it a beautiful ester profile, great mouthfeel, and a little trippy side effect. For now, we have three flavors ready, and the rest, we're still testing. Welcome to the fermentation singularity. Totally normal, right? But there are way cooler things actually coming through the InstaPint lineup. During development, we train our own AI agent for this, and soon you will be able to dial in your own beer using our AI agent. IPAI, you will be able to dial in beer style, wanted ABV, IBU, hop flavors, ester amounts, all of that goodness, and have it delivered right to your door, maybe by drone or puppy. We'll see. Introducing the InstantPint IPAI interface. Dial in your ideal brew, style, strength, bitterness, esters, hop character, and clarity. Name your creation or surrender to chance with a spontaneous pill roll. Behind the scenes, the IPAI engine parses your inputs, recalibrates molecular parameters, and fine-tunes the fermentation algorithm in real time. The result? A perfectly customized beer compressed into a single tablet, ready for instant activation. Welcome to the fermentation singularity. And also, I don't know if you see that, but there's literally no trub after the fermentation. So this yeast doesn't not only clean up after itself, it literally consumes itself into oblivion. I would actually prefer some more haze on this beer. It doesn't really live up to the name Hazy IPA, but hopefully the doctor can dial in the haze. But I didn't use RO water, I didn't use the exact amount that it said, so maybe I should stop bitching. So no trub, no sediment, no trace of the yeast, which means also that you can't harvest this yeast and steal our product. That is also what makes this beer clear, but we don't really want this amount of clarity on the hazy beers, but it needs to dial in. It's like perfect for the Pilsner, but I can't chug three beers here on a Sunday evening, as I'm also will record a Patreon video after this is done. Me and Shubin will have a Sunday beer. This doesn't count. This is for YouTube, and it's legally non-alcoholic, right? Don't drive on these. Just saying. Disclaimer. And as the NDA is lifted today, first day of the second quarter 2025, you will probably see a lot of videos popping up about this, because we sent a bunch of these out, but they're not available just yet. Keep an eye on my merch store, because there's where we will drop this first, and we're trying to get this out as soon as possible. And in the meantime, you're waiting for the pills to drop, we do have some merch, and I would love to have one here today, but the NDA was lifted today. What can you do? So yeah, this might sound like a gimmick, but it's really a fermentation revolution. It's like turbo yeast on steroids. And as there's no brewing gear really needed, and there's no cleaning, and doesn't take you very much time to get into this style of home brewing, if you want to call it that, it's totally girlfriend approved. So please drop a comment on which beer styles you want to see after these three pills are dropped. We have some questionable ones already in the making, but as you saw here today, these are still some tweaks that need to get into these original three ones before they drop. So keep an eye on the merch store so you can get first access when these three pills drops and get a swag there in the meantime. And seriously, don't eat the tablet. Take one, Ample, take one.